Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll install qemu, the Linux hypervisor. We will also install kvm, which can significantly improve its performance, and virt-manager, a graphical interface to handle the whole thing. I'm using a post from the Ubuntu community website to help me with the commands, but everything will appear in the description below. So, let's install qemu and kvm. Once the installation is done, we need to make sure that the user belongs to two groups, libvirt and kvm. Let's add the user to libvirt, which he already was a part of, and kvm. We need to log out so the user will actually be added to the two groups. Once we log back in, we can check the user's groups using the groups command. And we can see both kvm and libvirt. We can make sure that the installation was successful using the virsh command, which is part of the libvirt library. And we can see a list of our virtual machines, which is empty at the moment. The last installation is the virt-manager, which is a graphical interface for the virtualization tool. And we can open virt-manager. Let's create a virtual machine to see how we can actually use this virtualization tool. Let's download the Ubuntu server ISO file. I already have it, so I will not download it again. Let's create a new virtual machine, then select local install media. I'm adding the folder that holds my ISO file. QEMU identified that it's Ubuntu 20.04. But if the auto detection does not work, you can select it yourself. We choose how much RAM and how many CPUs we want to allocate for the virtual machine, and the size of its virtual disk. We need to name it. And the virtual machine starts, and we can install the operating system. Once the installation is done, we need to remove the virtual optical drive. To do that, we need to open the virtual machine details, where we can see all of the possible configurations for it. Among them, we have the CD-ROM drive, and we can see the ISO file that's currently loaded. To eject it, I'll delete everything from the path and click on Apply. And now I can get back to the virtual machine itself and restart it. And once it loads, we can log in and have a fresh Ubuntu server ready for use. Thanks for watching. And if you find this type of content useful, please consider subscribing.